Part 2. Verdant Wind. Guardian Moon. The Alliance Leader's Ambitions. Claiming the monastery at Garrig Mach as its home base, the Alliance Army joins forces with the Knights of Cerros. Together, they begin to take up arms against the Adrestian Empire.
Hilda, you didn't do much manual labor, but you managed to rope the knights into helping us restore the monastery.
Thanks, Claude, but all I did was piggyback on your scheme. I saw your eyes telling me to make some magic happen.
We appreciate your assistance with the restoration of the monastery.
Oh, please, it was nothing. We're just doing our part as former students.
I'm told you've been routed the bandits. That job should have fallen to us. I'm sorry for the trouble.
Hey, don't think twice about it. We're all allies in the resistance against the Empire, right?
The Church is at war with the Empire, but let's be realistic. Wouldn't it be better for the Alliance to eventually submit?
The way I see it, the Emperor wants to take over all of Fodlan and destroy the existing order of the world. I can't see her allowing the Alliance to continue to exist. We're in this just as deeply as you are. Actually, we were hoping to use this place as a base. The Empire begs to be meddled with, and we're first in line.
Why would you make your base here?
Garrig Mach is situated in the center of Fodlan, both geographically and spiritually. We want to secure this location while the Empire is still overlooking it.
I see. The Empire doesn't see this place as important at the moment, because it's far from the front lines.
But if we simply decide that it's ours to occupy, that does nothing to inspire the hearts and minds of the people of Fodlan. Luckily, good old Teach has finally returned to us. If the Professor Rhea entrusted with the Sword of the Creator fights at our side, well now, that's a just cause anyone could get behind. What's more, here we are, working alongside the legendary Knights of Cerros. It smacks of divine providence, doesn't it? Can you feel it?
I have heard what you have to say, Claude. And you, Professor? Where do you stand?
I want to fight Rhea.
We are at a relative standstill. With the help of the Alliance, the Archbishop said if anything should happen to her, that we should entrust the affairs of the Church to you. If you intend to fight alongside the Alliance, then I will follow you as well. Is that acceptable, Claude?
Of course. I can't think of anything more reassuring than having both Teach and the Knights on our side. Together, we'll stop the Emperor and her reckless ambitions.
Hey, Alice. Yeah, super sorry about late stream, but that's mostly due to the fact of, hey, I need to watch my baby niece for a bit, and I had a blackout earlier today that messed up my recording / streaming software, so I needed to take like 20 minutes to figure out what the crap was going on with that. Let's just say it wasn't fun.
Well met, Professor. I trust that you have not had any complaints about me lately.
Give me a second, there's a wire on the switch. I don't want that wire on the switch. Okay.
Oh, Professor, I trust that you've been,
thankfully, no.
Good. Please, accept my most sincere apology for any discomfort I may have caused you. I've decided that it would be inappropriate for me to continue my search for a spouse while we are at war. I expect that means you will not be receiving any more complaints. I hope that puts you more at ease. Actually, the introspection I've gained setting aside my search has motivated me to amend my conduct. Not the phrasing I choose, but you're not wrong. Selfishly pursuing my own desires caused me to behave inconsiderately.
It's also been like 5 years.
And rude to invite ladies to dine with me purely to evaluate them. Our experiences in battle have also given me cause to doubt certain preconceptions I once held. Previously, I had considered it a requirement for my future spouse to come from a noble line. I once thought that commoners lacked the power to influence the wider world, as history might suggest. To find a commoner who made a real impact, one has to look all the way back to Nemesis. That was my belief, at any rate.
Mm-hmm.
I realized that I've actually had an influential commoner right in front of me all along.
Dorothea?
Don't you see? I'm referring to you.
Now.
You may wield the power of oppressed, but you are so much more than just that. You have managed to charm everyone around you, to compel them to trust and follow you.
I fed them!
I realize it. That is no mean feat.
I fed them a lot of food.
Your example puts my prior beliefs
to the point of they probably will throw up. Several occasions.
I appreciate the kind words. I have always sought to embody the ideal of nobility. That, at least, is a goal I continue to stand by. But now I'm
that's good. To a degree.
Sufficient to gauge a person's worth. I've learned much of this from you. You are humble and open-minded, despite your power and skill. That is why I, at least, find you so charismatic. Perhaps that is the wrong way to say it. What I mean is that you set an admirable example. I can only hope someday to be your equal.
I mean, that's not technically wrong.
You had better keep an eye on me, because I can achieve anything I set out to do. For I am none other than the handsome and talented Lawrence Elman Gloucester.
Sure, Lawrence. Sure. Who the hell is going to be wowed by this dude? Unless you're very vain. I cannot see any chick liking Lawrence. Or have, like, no personal intentions of giving a crap about yourself. Also, I might have gone overboard with everything. I probably went overboard. Oh, sweet God. Okay. I know what we're going to be doing for like the next 4 hours.
The earth nurtures the trees, and the trees bear fruit. It's the earth itself that gives us all life. Oh, Fodlan, land of plenty, bless us with the gift of delicious food. What are you doing? It's just you, Lawrence. I was disturbed by your ridiculous blather. Must you recite it quite so loudly? And can you even call that nonsense poetry when it is utterly ignorant of rhyme and meter?
Ouch! You don't hold back, do you? I didn't know you were so particular about poetry. Ha! Maybe you have a secret poetry collection of your own hidden somewhere.
That's absurd! Where did you hear that? And just what was that poem about?
It you haven't before?
You're praising the land. But is it not the goddess who nurtures the land? Should your praise not go to her instead?
Of course you zero in on that detail. You really are a Fodlan noble through and through.
Certainly. Aren't you?
I'm not quite the same, no. Though noble blood flows within me, it can't change who I am at heart.
Pardon? I think you had best clarify.
Listen, Lawrence. You had ambitions of becoming the Alliance's ruler, didn't you? Would you like to try that for real? If you really want it, I wouldn't mind giving up my position.
What's this all of a sudden? That is not an offer to be made in jest.
I'm not joking around. I've been thinking it for a while now. I originally thought you were like a fox drawn in by the deer of the Alliance. But I was wrong. You're no thoughtless predator. You're trying to properly train the deer around you. Isn't that right?
That is my intention. But the ambition is insufficient. To rule well, a certain temperament is required. When we first met, I mistrusted you a great deal. And on my father's advice, I observed you closely. That is why I can say this for certain. You possess the qualities necessary to govern.
A compliment? From you? That's about as rare as a deer standing on its hind legs and doing a jig.
Merely a statement of fact. One that is quite relevant to the future of the Alliance.
The future of the Alliance, huh? You really are devoted to your cause.
Depending on your actions, I may yet see fit to seize your position for myself. Bear that in mind.
I welcome the idea. It means I can feel safe vanishing whatever I see fit.
Vanishing? Do not tell me you intend to die in this conflict. You cannot shape the future if you do not live to see it.
First you compliment me, and now you're worrying about me? What have you done with the real lords? No, I'm not going to die. I'm tougher than I look. Besides, this war isn't just for
you. You're also like the highest level. I would feel embarrassed if you died.
By yourself, don't you think?
Burden, please. If there were none other suitable, I would gladly become a king, or even an emperor.
Well, well. I guess I shouldn't take Lawrence of the famous House Gloucester so lightly. Really, though. Don't you go dying on me either, Lawrence. We're going to need men like you in the age to come.
If I can help it, I'm not going to let him die.
A world without you would be ever so dull.
They made up! They made up as friends! That's actually very, like, comforting to see. Also, let me go put my... Actually, I'll try... The wind isn't blowing, though. Ugh. Screw it, I'll put the AC on. My parents can yell at me all they want. It's not cold enough, I'm not getting enough wind in my room. My fan ruins the... helmet. Okay, who's next? Oh, filling up the ladies! All the ladies!
Strategically speaking, if I poised an archer to lie in wait here, and then lured the enemy in over here...
Lysithia, are you up late studying again?
I am, but I don't see how it's any of your business.
Look, you don't need to work yourself so hard. You're already as skilled as they come. There aren't many people out there who can match you. Everyone knows that.
I apologize for my sharpness. I just feel pressure.
Why would you, of all people, feel pressure?
I place a lot of personal pressure on myself. I need to become as strong as possible to put my parents at ease.
Really?
When I met with Count Ardelia before, he said you were his pride and joy. But he also said his only concern was that you might be pushing yourself too hard. If you really want to make your parents happy, surely you should start by taking care of yourself.
That's true.
Then it's settled. Get some rest.
I mean, I'm not wrong. He has the heart to, like, enjoy... Wow, that did sound wrong. But he does have the heart to, like, care for all of his, like, fellow classmates slash other nobles and stuff. Claude's one of those characters who's like, he starts off really dumb and careless in a sense. Like, he knows what he's doing, but he comes off as super dumb and careless, but he does really care.
Just after you finally earned a small degree of respect from me, too.
Hey, just think about it for a second. You're the only one in the world I treat like this. That means you're a pretty special person to me.
You think I'm special?
Take it however you like. Or maybe the thought is too much for a kiddo like you.
How dare you?
Yeah, but don't do anything you might regret. I don't want to be turned to dust.
I'm feeling generous, so I'll let you off easy this one time.
Well, that's good of you. All joking aside, go get yourself some shut-eye, okay? After all, if you don't hurry up, the boogeyman might come out and eat you.
All right, buddy, you asked for it.
I'm sorry, I really just like how Claude is that character who's just kind of like, how should I put this? More like, oh my god, a mushroom! I wonder what it does. It's poisonous. Well, I mean, it doesn't kill people. And it puts it in, like, their tea or something, and, like, diarrhea for the worst, like, day of your life. Like, Claude's just kind of like a jokester, I like. I mean, the best you can do is hear him out.
Once upon a time, in a faraway place.
What the? Are you telling me a story?
Just listen. Once upon a time, in a faraway place, there was a young boy. This boy came from a despised lineage. In short, his mother was a daughter of the enemy. So the young boy was treated horribly by everyone around him. He hadn't done anything wrong. Everyone hated him simply for existing. Yelling, fighting back, explaining himself. Nothing he did could change his situation. When he was finally old enough, he ran far away from home. He escaped.
It sounds to me like he had no choice. I would have done the same had it been me.
Thing is, after he ran away, he still found himself in the very same position. People in the outside world hated him for where he came from.
Well, now that's...
The boy thought he had no place to go. All he could do was destroy the boundary between the inside and the outside world.
Destroy the boundaries?
Right. If there was no outside and inside, just one side to share, then the people outside wouldn't have a reason to hate him anymore, right? It wouldn't be easy, but if he managed, he could shrug off that burden.
Huh.
The point is, people are born with burdens to carry. That much is undeniable. But whether they bind us or we cast them aside, that's up to us.
Now, is that exclusive to Marianne, or is that... Because, like, that... I don't know, because, like, I've only seen one of the games, and I didn't watch it completely through and read the story on it. But that reminds me of the game Ike was from, Path of Radiance? I think it's Dawn of Radiance was the first one. I think Dawn of Radiance, yeah. Ike was seen as, like, that... Well, he was the father of, like, a mercenary gang and stuff, but... I think Ike was also kind of hated within the mercenary gang, because he was that one guy who just thought he could do everything by himself or something. Once again, I haven't played it, nor have I read the story on it completely, but I feel like that's Ike. That's a nod to Dawn of Radiance. No, Path of Radiance.
Put that heavy burden down. It's time.
But I don't know if I can do it.
That can also imply with Claude, too, because I think people hated Claude for a bit.
I can help you.
The same? Claude, we have nothing in common.
Hey, did you see that, Dorte? Your friend just smiled at me.
Thank you for sharing your story. I suppose I could try casting aside burden, as you say. We can try together.
Let's do that. And when we're free, we can change the whole world.
That music's so good in these scenes. My god. Hilda, you're up next.
I feel like I'm drowning in responsibilities.
Good.
Claude, take my mind off it. Regale me with another of your weird childhood stories.
Okay, then. How about an old story from a foreign land that my dad told me when I was a kid? Once upon a time, there was a white camel that got separated from his herd. Was that story really worth bawling your eyes out over?
It was wonderful. Don't you know how moving that story is?
I feel like you're just really sensitive.
Until today, but seeing you bawling like that, I do appreciate it a little more now.
What's that mean?
Well, you're always fake crying, aren't you? Getting all misty-eyed to make people think you're a delicate flower.
What? You're awful. I only cry when I'm sad.
Bullcrap, Hilda.
But I can spot real tears from fake tears any day of the week.
I can't. I sure as hell can't.
You understand me so well. Maybe it's because you're no different.
How's that?
When you smile or laugh, it's not sincere. I can tell. I've only seen you genuinely smile a handful of times. Like when you're talking to the professor.
Wow, good one, Hilda. You hit me right in the gut. I guess you're right. I'm not so different from you in that way. But how did you come to realize that? Have you been watching me that closely?
I'm afraid so. My eyes seem to wander toward you of their own accord. Hold on. Forget I said that. I didn't say that.
Aw, Hilda.
I can do. Forgetting isn't something this crafty brain of mine is capable of. Besides, my eyes have a tendency to wander in your direction, too. How else do you think I found out about your fake crime?
Huh? What are you getting at?
Say, Hilda, once everything's settled down, do you want to come meet my parents? I mean, don't get the wrong idea. You just seem interested in my family. Besides, you've opened up to me quite a bit. But I still haven't let you in on my own secrets. If you meet my parents, I think you'll understand. Though it might come as a bit of a surprise.
Your family? I'd be lying if I said I wasn't curious.
Well then, if neither of us changes our minds before the opportunity presents itself, let's agree to go visit my home together.
Although, if it's a long journey, my brother might not be too happy.
True, that might be a tough nut to crack. As tough as Fodlan's locket.
I don't know, because, like, that sounds super forced to me. And not in the sense of, like line delivery and other things. I mean, it just sounds like... Yeah, I guess they're meant to be the canon ending situation stuff, but it's also just, like... I don't remember their past conversations, but it was just, like... Surprise! Y'all meet my parents, because I want to... do things. Eh.
Well, we've got another battle coming up. What do you think of our chances?
Winning is always the goal. At any rate, I've done everything I can to prepare.
That's the right attitude. I'm sure they're doing all they can on their side, too.
I don't doubt it, but however strong they are, it's no more than a Fodlan concern. Who knows how far this world extends beyond the boundaries of Fodlan? Talk of strength or weakness doesn't amount to much when it's only in relation to a tiny corner of the world.
Guess you're right. Thinking about it like that, even this war seems like a storm in a teacup.
Exactly. It's nothing more than an internal quarrel amongst the people of Fodlan.
Typical laid-back Claude.
Sorry being laid-back?
Your perspective on the world is so refreshing. Things I thought were obvious turn out not to be.
The way you think, that changes the way you see things. Common sense never tells the whole story. It's similar to what we were talking about before, about how you need to doubt yourself first.
True enough, but where did you get these ideas? That perspective of looking past the walls of Fodlan, when it's all we can see in front of us.
Do you really want to know?
I do.
But I'm afraid now isn't the time. When this war is won, I'll tell you all about it. It'll be easier for me to show you than to tell you.
Show me? Are we going somewhere?
It's quite a distance. You'll start to appreciate how big the world is if you go.
Sounds eye-opening. I'll look forward to it.
Has Claude traveled?
Promise?
Yes, it's a promise. But first, let's win this war and leave it far behind us.
Huh. Also, did I basically spoil what the relationship status is in this game? Or did people figure that out beforehand?
Sorry, Claude. You can't go past.
Huh? Ah, Cyril. It's you. Is there a problem? It's not the first time I've been to the Holy Tomb. Rhea herself took me there once. Besides, the inside's been scoured by the Imperial Army. There's nothing left there now.
Don't matter. Lady Rhea said nobody could go in, so I can't let you through. I gotta do what Lady Rhea says. You wanna break them rules, then you'll be her enemy. If you're trying to do that, I'll have to fight you.
Fine, I get it. I wouldn't hesitate to make an enemy of Rhea if it came to that. But I'd rather not fight with you. So I'll back off. For now.
Why is that?
Does it matter?
Dunno. With your status, you could smack me to the ground and walk right over me.
I guess. But I wouldn't. We're friends.
I thought you were the kind of guy who'd smack down just about anybody if you needed to.
You really are a stubborn one. All right then, I'll tell you. I swore I'd change this world so that those without status are no longer oppressed. Though you were never one of the people I was hoping to save. I never knew that there were people in Elmira in your kind of situation. I realized that my own perspective was too narrow. You helped me realize that. So, I owe you.
Did you just say you're all about saving people who are oppressed? Really?
I did. Is it so strange to hear that from me?
I mean, not really.
You reminded me of Lady Rhea there for a second. Lady Rhea always tried to save us folks without any status in the world. Like when she let an outsider like me stay at the monastery. That was real nice. She brought in those kids from Remire Village when they lost their parents, and...
Well, I'm not a religious man. I'm sure Rhea wouldn't want to be lumped in with a guy like me.
Lady Rhea didn't do those things because the goddess told her she should. She did it because she wanted to. I can tell you that.
I see. In that case, maybe I don't need to make an enemy of her. Thanks, Cyril. You brought me a step closer to my dream.
Thanks to you too, Claude. If I was able to help you, then that makes me happy.
Cyril's such a sweet kid. Am I the only one who thinks that?
Hey, Petra. Are you there?
Yes. What is your need?
Oh, I didn't actually think you'd be here.
You think I am not here, but you were calling for me.
It seemed best to call out as soon as I arrived. I can never tell when you're here, and it wouldn't be good for my heart if you just dropped in from out of nowhere.
When I was arriving, I called out for Claude, too. I was thinking it would give me joy if you were here.
Is that a fact? I'm honored. Anyway, I see you beat me here today. Say, Petra, wouldn't it be great if, no matter how bad the war gets, at least this place stayed peaceful?
Yes, I think so. I like this tree. It gives me calmness.
I like this tree too. It feels like it's always welcoming and reliable.
But when the war has ended, I must be leaving this tree. I must be returning to Bridget. Claude, my grandfather has been saying I must be... must find a husband, a Fodlan.
Whoa, where did that come from? Sly minx, have you been searching for a suitor all this time?
No?
If Fodlan
no to what?
Become bound by marriage, it will give my grandfather great joy.
Well, you are a princess, so it makes sense that you have obligations.
I am not having an obligation. I will only be marrying if I find a good person.
So, you just need to find a man who meets your expectations. That could be tricky.
No, I will be finding one. It will not be a problem.
Oh? And who's the lucky fellow?
It is my secret. I will not be telling him yet.
I see. Do you think he can give you the kind of future you deserve?
I am not knowing about the future. But my perfection... my perfect husband could be him. And if he gives refusal, I will be tying him up and dragging him home.
Well, I'm sure the lucky man will learn to accept his fate one way or another. Besides, I doubt any man would reject a proposal from a catch like you.
Lawrence with holy crap, everybody! Pretty damn close to everyone.
Lysithia, it's no good for you to expose yourself to such strong sunlight. And a chill could steal upon you at any moment. You really ought to have worn a mantle.
That's a question you asked about someone being a nice thing.
Enough is enough. I am fully aware.
Wow, I can't remember what I said. Holy cow.
I'm only concerned for your health.
That's great and all, but I feel fine today, and I'm perfectly capable of caring for myself. I don't have time to take a rest. I'm overloaded with work, and I have less time than everyone else. I just want to do my own thing. Bring order to the Alliance, and put my parents' minds at ease.
No need to rush. How can you be so certain your lifespan is shortened anyway? I do not know who decided that, but consider me skeptical. If you are healthy now, and if you take proper care of yourself, you ought to live just as long as anyone else.
That's all well and good, but those vitamin-packed sweets you brought tasted weird.
If you want a healthy body, then you need to start with what you eat.
You have a point, but those health sweets are gross.
I sent for the finest in wholesome, healthy treats for you. I asked only for the very sweetest.
That was pretty nice of you. I'm sorry, Lawrence. Thank you for being so thoughtful.
I mean, Lawrence has a good heart. He just has a really dumb way going about it.
Gaining a ton of weight won't exactly lengthen my lifespan either. I mean, I'd like to be able to hang out with you as much as possible. As long as possible.
Truly? Oh, I'm so glad.
She might have other obligations.
Perfect future. I still cannot see.
Don't mistake that for something else.
In fact, the more time we spend together, the more essential to me you become. So let us walk side by side.
She might have other obligations.
Keep it down, will you?
Why are you flustered?
Ah, but she likes it.
Not worry about a thing. I will look after you no matter what may come. After all, the future of Fodlan rests upon my shoulders, does it not?
I won't give up on myself either. Thanks for caring, Lawrence.
Not exactly. Wow, I messed my button up. Not exactly the sweetest thing, but I mean, it worked.
Most fascinating. Would you permit me to offer you tea as a token of my gratitude?
I'm a little busy right now. Maybe later tonight?
Of course. I will look forward to it.
Thank you for inviting me over.
Certainly. Thank you for coming. Oh, and please, relax. This is no formal occasion.
Oh, this tea tastes so good.
Doesn't it just? This is my absolute favorite. I'm pleased you like it. This pastry may suit your palate also. It is commonly paired with this tea in my homeland.
It's sweet. It complements the astringency of the tea.
You guys also come from the Lesser Alliance.
There is plenty more where that came from. We simply must do this again.
You want to spend more time with me?
Naturally.
Well, that's... Actually, there's something I need to say.
Yes? What is it?
I've been keeping this from you for a while.
It's
about my crest. Terrible.
I was like, is it gonna get like super dark? What the crap?
You're trembling. If uttering this secret hurts you, then I have no desire to hear it.
It's just...
Your smile is a greater gift to me than any truth. Whatever you have hitherto concealed, I am certain it is essential to you, and I do wish to know it. But not until the day arrives when you can tell me with a smile on your face. I am not the sort of man to prize my own knowledge over others' happiness, you know.
You're better than me sometimes, Lon. Holy cow.
You're funny, Lawrence.
There. What I mean, you're Your beauty is always captivated, but that smile truly warms my heart.
This is the first time I've smiled in so long, and I have your kindness to thank for that.
As I've said, you are perfect.
I mean, Claude helped you. Everyone else helped you.
I can take a little credit. Yes, your radiant smile shall illuminate all the world. With me by your side, you will not be able to help it.
I'm looking forward to that.
Hilda? Ah, a letter from your brother?
That's right. Though part of me thinks it's some stranger imitating my brother's handwriting. He's never given me this much praise. Hilda, you've learnt the value of persistence. You're really maturing, stuff like that. Usually his letters are like, I'm worried about you, and stop being so lazy.
Since I have fought by your side, I can assure you that his praise is genuine and entirely deserved.
I've written about fighting in plenty of letters. Why is he so gushy this time around?
I would venture to guess that your depictions of battle are more passionate than before. It's no surprise that such authenticity would resonate with a veteran warrior like your brother.
If that's true, I have you to thank. You've inspired me to throw myself into battle. Does everyone think I'm a tough warrior now? I don't want to be stuck with their high expectations.
Would that be so terrible? You are gifted, you know. Not to say that your lackadaisical nature has failed to endear itself to me.
I'll choose to take that as a compliment.
Speaking of letters, did you keep your promise? Did you, mention me?
I did. I told my brother all about you. I said you were a uniquely gifted leader who could inspire people to be their best selves. And I said that you'd be a real asset to the Alliance. I also told him how I wished you could join our family. He responded that he'd be honored to call you his brother.
Whoa, what the hell?
Valiant brother would be beyond my wildest expectations.
Lawrence, you know what I mean about you joining our family, right?
I believe I do. And I confess, if I am correct, the same thought has preoccupied me as well. But you must forgive me. Now is not the time.
True.
Before we can consider our own future, we must first end this war.
I think that Hilda and Lawrence would be a little better than Hilda and Claude.
A peaceful world, then what? Come on! Just say it.
As much as I'd like to grant that request, I cannot. This is something that will deeply affect our lives.
Have a great stream. I noticed that you were streaming. Nice stream.
And the perfect offering. I am.
Are you not staying, Rose? After all.
I'm not usually one for waiting around, but maybe I'll make an exception in his case.
Okay, Claude's almost done. Or Claude,
hey,
Lawrence.
Got a minute?
Leone, we to sharpen swords again?
No, I came to give you this handkerchief back. Sorry, I know I held on to it for a while. You lent me this, remember?
I recall giving it to you. It is a noble's duty to give to the common folk. In return, the commoner need only pay respect.
That's nice. You left out the part where the nobles take all the stuff the regular folks make?
Yes, the common folk give the fruits of their labor, willingly, I might add, as a token of that respect. The head of Saan Village offers his tribute in exactly that spirit, you know.
Saan? That's my village. You knew?
Of course. We granted exclusive hunting rights to Saan, and forbade outsiders from poaching. In fact, when we received complaints about just that, we hired mercenaries to deal with the issue.
So that's what brought Gerald.
What was that?
Nothing. Look, just take the handkerchief. I'm returning something I borrowed from a friend.
Very well. As your friend, I will accept it.
You know, I really wish you wouldn't think of nobles as always giving and commoners as only receiving. Friends help each other, without thinking about status. And that help goes both ways.
Quite so. And when I require the aid of a friend, I assure you I will happily recognize it. But only with friends. In the main, I must continue to refuse assistance from the common folk. For a noble to accept would be disgraceful.
Huh. I always thought he was just stuck up. Turns out, he just has this grand idea of nobility he's trying to live up to.
I mean, yeah, that's kind of how it works.
Maybe even give him the handkerchief.
I don't think he wants it at this point, Leonie. Oh my god. Ignatz, you're up.
Hey, Raphael. Reading a letter? Well, if it isn't old Ignatz, I got a message here from my sis.
Oh, a letter from Maya. I haven't seen her in so long. I bet she's all grown up.
Nah, she's still a shrimp. It's been a while since I saw her. But she's probably only up to your shoulders.
Wow. I can't believe she's gotten that tall.
I wrote to tell her about how we're friends again. Do you remember this?
Is that the picture I drew for her?
She sent it along with the letter. I guess she held on to it since we were kids. All right, that's enough looking. She said to show it to you and send it right back.
To think she's handling my little doodle with such reverence. It warms my heart. I remember the day I gave Maya that drawing. She looked so happy. Before then, I never knew I could make people happy with art. It was a revelation. I've been drawing and painting ever since, in hopes of becoming an artist one day.
You're much better now, so it must be paying off! I bet you could be a real artist.
No, that's not possible, I'm afraid. I have to consider my parents' wishes.
Who cares what your parents want? It's not like you're a noble or nothing. Your fate is your own!
Huh. You think so?
Yes.
I know so. And I'm gonna support you with whatever.
Everyone's been telling you this for years now, probably.
What's the first step to follow your dreams? Oh, got it. You should paint me.
Paint you?
Yeah. I want my little sis to know how good I'm doing here. So I gotta send her proof. Plus, she'll be doubly impressed if it's a painting you made.
Good point. I can certainly try to capture your likeness. I'll paint you with a warm, cheerful expression on your face to bring Maya comfort.
My face? No way! You gotta get my muscles in there! Mostly my chest and arms.
Are you sure that's what she'd want to see?
Wait! Before you start painting, I gotta get me a little more training in. If my muscles aren't bulging, then what's the point?
Raphael, you're dumb. Raphael, you're a dumb.
Huh? Is that Ingrid? I'd better get out of here before she scolds me again. Actually, she looks kind of sad. Maybe I shouldn't run away. Hey! Ingrid! Why do you look so sad? Are you hungry or something?
Oh, it's you. No, I'm not hungry.
You're not hungry? But you're sad anyway? I don't get it. Are you sick?
No.
I know.
I'm sure you're not hungry.
Raphael, you're so dumb.
That wasn't it. It's nothing you can help with anyway.
Well, sometimes you gotta talk it out. That's what my grandpa says.
Yeah, I guess that's helpful sometimes. Are you willing to listen then?
Of course! Please, go ahead.
I found a letter from back at the academy that my father sent regarding a marriage arrangement with a noble family.
I see.
I am the only person in House Galatea capable of carrying on our family line, passing on a crest.
I see.
Oh god, Raphael.
I chose instead to fight. Betraying my family and ruining my father's plans for me.
I see.
Raphael, just shut up and listen.
Raphael, are you even listening?
I'm right there with you, but...
Did you hear that ominous sound? Was that thunder?
Sorry. All that listening made me hungry. After hearing you out, I think you're probably just hungry too. And your troubles are sure to go away after a good meal.
I really am not hungry. But I can't say no to good food. All right. Let's just eat then. I can tell you about my struggles some other time, maybe.
With Raphael, probably never. Go bottom top.
Hey, writing to your sister again?
You bet. Gotta reply to these things as soon as they come in.
You had one last week, too. It's great to see you're both so good about staying in touch. It's especially important when there's a war going on.
Yeah. Oh, that reminds me. My sister wrote to say how much she loved the painting supplies you sent.
Good. I'm glad gathering those pigments paid off.
You even made her a brush. I really appreciate you doing all that for her.
I was fascinated with painting at that age. I was a pretty artistic kid, if you can believe it. Not a lot of time for it when you're hungry, though.
Honestly, no.
I had a pretty tough time growing up, too, huh?
I guess so. We never thought of it that way. But it's true, the children in my village don't usually get to choose their futures. Any one of us could have had the talent for artistic genius and never even noticed. I was one of the lucky ones. I only got to follow my passion thanks to my father and all the other folks. That's why, once I come into my own, the first thing I'll do is head back there and help the other kids.
Oh, wow. It's like all the kids in your village are counting on you.
No need to exaggerate it. Besides, it's not like I'm unique. You're working hard for your sister's future, aren't you?
Yeah. It's like me and you are both carrying big weights. We should try sharing the weight with each other. You know, lighten both of our loads.
Huh?
What?
We share our problems. Then we only gotta carry half the weight, right? It works out for everybody.
It's probably a good thing you didn't try to take on your family's business. If you take half of my burden and I take half of yours, the total is still the same.
Nah, that doesn't sound right. Everything's lighter when you don't gotta carry it alone.
Emotional support?
On second thought, you might be right. With the right attitude and the right partner to share the burden, maybe it is only half the weight.
Now you get it! It's a waste of energy to struggle alone when there's someone who can help you.
That's true. And I do hate waste, as you well know. So when it comes to working toward the future you're after, you know I won't fall short.
Great! And you should never fall short on sharing a big meal with me, too!
Deal.
Once again, just like Lawrence, I don't understand how someone could love Raphael. Just a little stupid.
Hey, Raphael.
He's got good words, but a little stupid. God damn it, Hilda.
Gorgeous. Beautiful. I've never seen anything like it. Thank you, Hilda.
Whoa, hold up. What's with the blubbering?
It's just, I bet my sister never got anything so pretty in her whole life. She's had to deal with so much because of me. I never got her anything this nice and cute before. She's gonna love it and be so happy.
Okay. Yes, okay, that's enough. Come on, you're embarrassing me here. If you're really that happy, I'm glad I put some effort into something once.
Don't you always put effort into things?
That's sweet of you, but no, I don't want to put in effort and then disappoint people. It's dispiriting, not to mention tiring.
But what if they're...
Sounds like my mentality.
They feel great, and you feel great too.
Yeah, you have a point there. I guess I'm realizing that now. You know, thanks to you, I'm starting to see things from my brother's perspective.
What do you mean? Do you have a big bro too?
I do. I've always thought of him as an overprotective nuisance, but now I feel thankful. Looking at you, I couldn't help but think, sometimes big brothers are okay.
I didn't do anything special, though. It's natural for a big bro to look after his little sis. Oh, that reminds me. I still haven't found anything special enough to repay you for the necklace. I got an idea, though. How about I help you make a tough-looking necklace for your big bro?
No need. I have a better idea. When the wars simmer down, why don't you and your sister come visit me?
Really? That's it?
Yeah, I want to make sure it suits her. And then I can adjust the cord if I need to.
Of course we'll come visit. I told my sis all about you, and she already wants to meet you.
Well, good. I look forward to it. In the meantime, hold me close to your heart.
What?
That's what the necklace would say if it could talk. Hold me close to your heart.
Aww. That's too subtle for Raffaello, though. That's way too subtle. He's not going to understand. Raffaello's like that big dog. Everyone knows that big dog that everyone loves. And it's just like no one understands what the big dog wants. Oh, God.
Do you mind if I handle this? Hello there, Mr. Bird. How do you do? Yes, I see. I see. So your food supply is...
No, someone broke my eggs!
I completely understand. I have seen more people and birds foraging for berries lately. It would be ideal if those berries were growing in another forest nearby. Then you wouldn't have to...
Are you hungry, Mr. Bird? I got just what you need.
Are those bugs? Yuck.
Look at him go. He's loving it. He's gonna get so big and strong after this.
That was disgusting. But how did you know he was hungry?
Basically what you're telling him?
Looking at him. He looked hungry and weak. More importantly, I saw what you did. That bird wasn't speaking human. So you gotta understand birdies.
Oh, God.
I knew it.
Oh, about that. I'm sorry, Raphael. But I need to tell you the truth. I can sort of understand what animals are thinking when I look at them. But I can't speak to them. I'm sorry for leading you on.
I mean, I have the same kind of thing, oddly enough.
Not. You're not even looking at me. You gotta look at my eyes.
Nope, still can't do it.
I guess I just gotta tell you. I'm thinking it would be nice if you talked to me the way you talk to animals.
What do you mean?
Soft and gently?
Whenever you talk to animals, you seem happy and friendly.
Ow!
I just wish you'd talk to me like that too.
I mean, you guys are close enough to be friends.
I didn't know.
What if I tried this?
Get a laugh, get a laugh.
Whoa! I've never heard you laugh before! I should have talked to you and Birdie sooner. Cheep charade, cheep woo, teedledee!
Hell, he's gonna laugh out of me.
Sorry, I didn't quite catch that one.
I said you gotta eat bugs to grow big and strong, just like Mr. Bird.
I think I'll have to pass.
I mean, the mood's still there. He just kinda put a bug in between them. Man, Raphael, I wish I was kind of more like you, just kind of oblivious and stupid.
Need help with something, Lysithia?
I can't find the ladder anywhere, and I needed to check out the books up on that top shelf.
Want me to just grab one for you?
No, I need to be able to dig around myself.
No problem. You can sit on my shoulders and...
Yep, I was just going to say that. Hold on, Steve. Use the height of a taller person to your advantage.
I hope nobody saw that. Anyway, thank you. That was helpful.
His head will cover your skirt area. You're fine.
Thanks for being so patient while I rummaged.
No problem at all. It was my pleasure.
Hey, Raphael. You're always extra nice to me.
He's nice to everyone.
That's probably why she grew up to be the kind of kid who wants to do everything on her own.
That's certainly something I can relate to.
I keep telling her that it's okay to rely on her big bro a little bit. Like, when there's stuff she can't do because she's too small, she just needs to ask someone bigger to do it. I told her that she could help me when I'm having trouble with stuff too. Then we would be even.
Young or old, we can all help one another out. We each have our strengths and weaknesses. Receiving help and providing help in return. It sounds so simple, really.
It is
simple. I knew you'd get it.
I do. And I hope you understand.
What with that condescending tone you took at the right at the end?
Only one receiving aid. It makes me feel incompetent and like a kid. I hate that.
Alright then. You can help me clean up my room.
I bet it's a disaster knowing you. I'll help you on that front, but I've got some rules on how to keep things tidy. You'll need to listen up.
If you could help with the actual tidying, that would probably be better. No need to bother with rules. I don't really do so good with remembering the complicated stuff. Oh, I got an idea. It would be even better if you could just come by and tidy up from now on.
What?
If you keep helping me, then I can help you whenever you need it. No guilt.
Whenever I need it, huh? How long does that offer hold?
From now on. Like, for always. I don't know what's so difficult to understand.
Oh my god, Raphael, this actively hurts me. This actively hurts me, Raphael. Also, can someone please draw... Oh god, which line was it?
I'll help you on that front, but I've got some rules on how to keep things tight. You'll need to listen up.
Can someone please take this line and give Lysidia like a little winky? Not a little wink. A little wink on her face, like her bigger eye has a wink. I feel like that would be kind of like a smug move on her, and she kind of does come off as a smuggish character. Anyone want to do that? Anyone want to take charge of that one? Probably a better line from her.
I can't be the only one receiving aid. It makes me feel incompetent and like a kid. I hate that.
Kind of like a frown face on that one. People want to listen to my dumb requests.
I do. And I hope you understand that you can come to me for help too, Raphael.
Probably a smirk on that one. Not really a smirk, but like an awkward smile. I don't think she would smile much. But I definitely want that winky face. Yeah. That's you guys.
For always sounds nice. I'm fine with that.
Ugh. Oh, we're not remotely done. Yay!
Something I can do for you?
Can you help me out with my shopping?
Yes, of course. You need me to carry stuff?
Actually, can you pick up some tea for me? I'd do it, but I'm drowning in work.
You're so busy you can't go shopping. Okay. Do you have a favorite kind of tea?
I'm not too picky. I just like having it around, really. Whatever's cheapest works for me. Here's some money.
One question. Why me? You don't really need my help for this.
I just thought I could lean on you a bit. You know, rather than trying to do everything on my own.
Right, I see. Well, good. I'm glad you decided to approach me. But for this particular task, you might be better off doing it yourself.
Oh?
There are so many different kinds of tea, and I'm not very discerning. Well, what if I get you one you don't like? When I do my own shopping, I pick a tea at random. Otherwise, I'd be paralyzed by all the choices. It's the same with food. Sometimes I stare and stare at the options and never decide.
You look like you were doing just fine when you went to get groceries the other day.
I really had to push myself to do that alone. I don't think I can do that again. Sorry.
Just like me.
You've stopped trying to do things on your own, then?
Yeah. Still, though. For today, how about you have some of my tea? If that'll do.
Sounds nice, sure. Do you mind brewing mine while you're at it?
Okay. Though I can't do it as skillfully as Lawrence, I'm afraid. I'll get it ready right away. Feel free to start focusing on your work.
Alright, considering the second half of the game, I want people to start doing this, and it spoils the ending, technically.
I do.
I'll wait until we're done the conversation.
You're fun, you're easy to be around, and you rarely complain when you help others.
Well, I'm just pouring you some tea.
I complain a lot.
Qualifies as help.
It's not easy for me to rely on people, but with you, it's different.
Well, there aren't many things I can do, frankly. What I can do, I will do. So if you need anything, ask me, and I'll try to help.
You really are unreliable, as it turns out. Guess I'll just have to take your word for it.
I mean, at least he's honest with you. Also, it spoils the ending, but I don't give a crap at this point. Who do you guys want to pair up in the ending? Who do you think will end up having a romance with who? I honestly do think Raphael and Leonie will have, like, an ending credit or ending credit sequence with them. Claude and Pyra. I want to say Lawrence and Marianne. But, I mean, I'm also just talking right out of my butt.
I saw you on the training grounds earlier. It looked like there was an argument.
Oh, no. It was nothing.
Are you sure? Nothing happened at this morning's training?
Well...
Okay. Tell me what happened.
I just couldn't keep up with the rest of the group. Everyone got so mad at me. They said something about looking into their eyes so I could read their movements. But I couldn't do it.
They may have a point.
You're a healer. Stay in the back.
To everyone, I can't do it.
Of course not. That goes without saying. It's hard to accomplish anything on your own. Look at me. By myself, I'm worse than useless. Can you see where I'm going with this? To succeed, you have to cooperate. You can't do that if you're not paying attention to nonverbal cues.
Huh?
Please, try looking up. Looking people in the eye. You'll see some things that you've never seen before. People worry about you, and rely on you. You'll see that on your allies' faces. In a way, you'll see what they're thinking.
unless you're you're facial blind like I am.
I appreciate your encouragement.
Of course.
I honestly cannot read someone's face that well.
I saw the sunset and appreciated its beauty. Nature communicates without words. We can do the same. We don't need to speak to be understood. Stop staring at your feet. Look at us. That'll be a good start.
I can certainly try. Is something wrong? Did I say something to upset you?
Oh no, to the contrary. I just realized that I was missing something. A thing of remarkable beauty. Right under my nose.
Remarkable beauty?
What? Don't mind me.
Oh, Ignatz! Ignatz, man! You are... I wouldn't necessarily say an angel, but you weren't exactly far off.
Oof. Capsized the teapot. Tea leaves on the carpet. This'll be fun to clean up.
How?
Is something wrong?
Ignatz, I accidentally knocked over my teapot. I drunk all the tea already, thank the goddess, but the tea leaves went right into the carpet.
Oh, that's a mess. Here, let me help. I can leave stains if you're not careful.
But don't you have somewhere to be?
Oh no, don't worry. I'm on a break.
What's that in your hands? Oh, painting supplies. You were gonna go do some painting, weren't you?
Ah, yes. The weather's quite splendid, and I found a place where some gorgeous flowers are blooming. But the flowers aren't going anywhere this second. Let's clean this up.
The carpet?
Okay.
The carpet, guys. Carpet.
Thanks, Ignatz, and sorry to keep you away from your painting.
That's okay. It didn't stain, at least. You picked all the leaves out of the carpet.
Still going painting? Or is it too late in the day?
No. I think time-wise it'll be fine. If you're not doing anything, Hilda, would you care to join me? I'm sorry, I didn't mean to make you uncomfortable.
Hilda, give me a minute. I need to do all of my makeup and I will bring my Switch.
Well, no.
Because why not?
I thought you didn't want to.
I never said I didn't want to. I was just surprised. I'd love to see those pretty flowers you mentioned. I'm glad you invited me.
Oh, that's good. Wait, you're glad?
Of course I am. I like being invited to things, silly.
Right, of course. It's affirming.
Yeah, exactly. See? You get it. So there's no need to worry that an invitation is burdening someone. It feels good to be asked.
Of course. Well then, in addition to seeing the flowers with me, would you like to help with my painting?
I wouldn't want to screw up your opus. I'm not much of a painter.
No, I meant that I'd like to paint you. Flowers all around you. Oh, that's too much, isn't it?
That would look amazing! I want to see that now!
Silly, you didn't even...
Anyone? Anyone in chat?
I'm not a...
Sorry for making so many requests?
Can you make that happen?
Huh? Yes, of course. I'll paint you cute as a button.
Good. Shouldn't be too hard. I can feel a very cute smile coming on.
Alice is probably looking at her screen and is like, I'm going to kill you. I am going to come to Canada, find where you live, tie you down, and probably bring your toes off.
I was thinking of adding a little color to my latest piece, so...
Come to think of it, I've still never seen your work. Here, let me take a peek.
It doesn't work like that. You have to let me know in advance. I need time to prepare.
Lighten up. Wow, look at all that paper. Are these all drawings? What should I look at first?
Wherever we travel, I try to capture the feeling and character of the landscape. I guess they've all kind of piled up. Each place is unique. not just the geography, but also the clothing and architecture and so on. Everywhere has its own design sensibilities.
Yeah, you'd think there'd be only one way to do stuff like engraving, but it actually varies a lot.
Just within the Alliance, the styles are quite different between the North and South, and the Empire's even more diverse.
Oh, here's a landscape. What a bright blue sky. You really make it seem alive.
The blue of the sky changes with the season, too. In the summer, it's darker, and yet in the winter, it's almost luminous. And, of course, the landscape below affects the sky's appearance by virtue of contrast. It's hard to get the color just right, so I spend a lot of time experimenting with pigments and... Oh no. I'm so sorry. I've been talking your ear off.
She likes it.
Listen, Ignatz. You need to become a painter.
Huh?
Don't say it's not useful. Your talent moves people. Someday, I'm sure your art will save someone's life.
Oh no, I wouldn't go nearly that far.
No, there are some artists that help with depression. Mostly because they have it.
You're only just starting out. Think about what you could do now that you've had so much practice. This is your calling.
You think so?
Yeah. It's something you can do that no one else can. I envy you. I wish I had a gift like that. So stop apologizing for your talent and just do it.
Thank you, Leonie. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have a lot to think about.
I also kind of want, like, an actual ideal picture of that, where, like, Leonie's flipping through pages and, like, Ignatz is just, like, off to the side, kind of, like, waving his hands or, like, trying to, like, imitate something. Like, I feel like he'd be one of those guys who just, one of those guys who does that. Anyone else sharing my sentiments on that? I mean, that's kind of a backwards compliment.
What did I just say?
I wonder if that coughing was, like, the actual voice actress that had, like, a really bad coughing fit, or was that more, like, oh, whatever, acting coughing. Because I know some people who can act cough. I cannot act cough for the life of me. I have done acting before, and so it's one of the very few things I can't do in acting, oddly enough, is, like, cough on command. Then again, I'm also not that great of an actor, so... yeah.
Ooh, you're keeping your room really tidy these days, Hilda. I'm pretty good at cleaning, I found out. I guess I was being lazy before. I figured that if I left it to somebody else, I might lose another vase. I'm sorry again about that. And about all of the other things I knocked over, too. Yeah. The shelves, and the chairs, and the clothes, and the makeup. Ugh, I'm sorry. I said I'm sorry.
My god, how much do you knock over?
I'm kidding. You know, Annette, you should try to be a little more selfish. Hmm? That was a quick change of subject. You said how hard you've been working not to disappoint your family. You cleaned my room, or tried to, because I was feeling overwhelmed. You're always taking on other people's burdens. You might be right. It could be nice to do something for myself sometime. But if I hadn't tried hard for other people's sakes, maybe I wouldn't have tried at all. I might not have made it this far. So really, I don't regret a thing. Who I am now is the sum of everything I've done. You're so soft-hearted, Annette. You really think so? I didn't mean it as a compliment. But anyway, I just thought of something you can do for me. You can take a nap with me. A nap? I'm not done with my chores. Yeah, I could use a little shut-eye, and it feels nice to snuggle up with someone. So, why don't we lie down for a bit?
Potentially awkward?
Are you sure it's okay to nap right now? I still have stuff to do for the professor. Oh, it's fine. It's fine. Later I'll help you with your stuff, and it'll be done in...
Please, for the love of God, tell me we get a little CG about this.
Just for a bit.
I just kind of want Hilda to just snort off of the side, and then just, like, awkwardly looking up in the ceiling, just going like, well, this is my life now. Never mind.
Already dozing. She must have needed this nap really bad. I'm feeling a little drowsy myself. Sleep well, Annette.
I probably made that a little more creepier than I had to be, but I just kind of like the idea of, like, Annette just kind of looking off in the ceiling and just going like, well, a nap does sound nice, but... Darp. That's all I have to say to that. Just darp. Oh, great. You thought we were done! Hi, Leonie. Sure. Let's spend time together.
Hey, Professor. Can we talk?
Sure.
I feel terrible about the last time we spoke.
You kind of yelled at me.
I'm trying to apologize and just ended up losing my temper again. I'm really sorry.
And, you know, it's been 5 years.
I figured you'd say that. But I still feel like an idiot.
Oh, trust me, we all do.
I have a hard time keeping my feelings in check around you. And I think if I don't just tell you what I'm thinking, we'll never be able to have a normal conversation.
Also, let's get a roll call in chat. Who's still here?
I want us to, engage. Yeah, wait, what? No, I mean in a duel. I know it's a sudden thing to ask, but I'm not going to feel settled until I know where I stand. Would you do that for me?
Sure.
Good. Don't hold back, okay?
Hello, Yosuke from Persona 4.
You got me. I'm completely outmatched.
You did hold your own, I'm imagining.
But you were definitely stronger. Honestly, that's what I needed to see. You're a true successor to Captain Gerald's style of swordplay. I almost felt like you were him. I thought I was competing with you. But that's as pointless as competing against him would have been. So instead of that, I'm going to focus on keeping the promise I made to him.
That was?
Captain Gerald said that if anything should happen to him, I'd have to support you in his place. He didn't sound serious at the time, but it was before he, you know, before we lost him. So I've decided I'd like to do just what he said.
Thank you?
I know I'm not as strong as I need to be, but I swear to you, I'll train until I am.
I mean, chat seems to like you, so, I mean, that's not a bad thing.
Yes, it's official. I'll protect you no matter what.
How does chat actually feel about Leonie? You guys don't talk enough.
Professor, something's been bothering me. Remember that suspicious guy I chased after back when I was a student? A knight scolded me for it, but at the time, I really thought I was doing the right thing. Now that I've had more experience on the battlefield, though.
I've been looking for you. There isn't much time, so I'll keep this brief. The knights encountered a band of brigands while out marching. It was hard fought, but we prevailed. Our soldiers are highly trained, but the enemy was formidable. We weren't expecting combat. There were a number of casualties among our troops. There is something I wanted to bring to your attention. Do you recall the incident 5 years ago involving a suspicious individual in Garrick Monk? These brigands all bore the same scorpion tattoo that we found on the arm of that man.
Oh no.
I thought that might be of interest to you.
He did that purposely, didn't he?
If you'll excuse me, I need to get back to my duties.
Heck of a coincidence, right? As soon as I mention that suspicious guy, this happens. But some of the knights died in combat. They died because of what I did 5 years ago. This is my fault.
Not necessarily.
If we tracked the guy down like you said, we would have stopped those brigands sooner, and I wouldn't have blood on my hands.
That's... You help the children. That's the bigger goal.
Probably wouldn't have. Now those knights, they're not coming back. We both know it. This is all my fault.
True, but no, it's not your fault. Because how the hell would you see 5 years in the future? There's numerous outcomes that could have happened. Each one of them being more deadly than the last. The fact that we lost some is something you have to take for consideration and keep that in your head. While yes, it would be ideal to lose no one, you're not going to have that in life. No one's going to get that lucky and no one's going to be that... shit. Well, pull my knees down and call me Sally. Yeah. It's impossible. Just don't let it weigh on your mind much.
How incredible. What a striking color. Professor, look at this stone. Such a brilliant blue. You don't normally find stones like this around here. I'm gonna grind it down. I wonder if it would still be the same color. So make pigment for my art. Good supplies don't come cheap. I prefer to make my own. Blue is especially expensive. We're fortunate that I chanced upon this remarkable blueness. I'm sorry. There I go again, blathering on and on about painting.
I like it.
Oh, yes. But I know that I can get rather caught up in it and, enthusiastic. You know, Professor, no matter how impassioned I become about my art, you never hold it against me. One could argue that I'm better off preparing for our next battle. I am becoming a knight.
You become an artist.
Oh, Professor, please don't say things like that.
You should!
I gave up on my artistic dreams long ago.
Bullcrap.
To support my family, I will be a knight. That's that.
You know, at this point, Ignis, screw your family. Will you regret that choice?
No. I know it's the right thing to do. I'll continue with my art as a hobby. I don't think I could ever give it up. When I see something beautiful, I can't suppress the urge to paint it. I don't have a choice.
Then become a freaking artist.
Even one person. Good enough for me.
Not you're sure.
Professor, I have a favor to ask. I'm painting a portrait right now. When it's finished, I'd like to give the piece to you. Would you take it? Perhaps it can bring you
yes.
happiness. That will have made the effort well worth it. Oh, excellent. Is that a promise? Because I'm really going to put my heart in it. That is, I'm going to enjoy partaking in this casual hobby of mine.
Ignos, dude, just, your family clearly, I mean, you care for your family, that's good and all, but I can't say the thing is mutual and going around properly, because your family could just be saying, you know what, what's a high-paying job, and what would probably get Ignos killed the fastest? Becoming a knight, sure! I have fear and trust issues. This should be very apparent.
Need something.
I hate you so much. We will max one of these out by the end of this run, I swear to God. And hopefully on the third run, we don't have to worry about, like, that much in general.
Professor.
Shamir, hi! Talk to me.
Thanks for your help out there. Battles tend to go smoother with you around. I can count on you doing most of the heavy lifting. It may be unwise to think this way on the battlefield, but I feel I can trust your commands without question.
That's good, because I've played this game for a long time already.
Not sure. I might have an idea, but never mind. I've also noticed that you've been putting me in more precarious situations lately. Almost like you know I won't question your orders. I'm glad you trust me to get the job done, but still, I knew you were doing it on purpose. You're in a very important position now that you're leading the charge against the Empire. Funny to think you used to just teach at the Officers Academy. Your old students still call you Professor. That's no title for the commander of an army.
I don't hate it. I actually like it.
You'll always be their professor, huh? You sure are an interesting one. My people lost the war, and I was left to wander Fodlan alone. But I guess meeting you was my prize. You look confused. Did you not know any of this? I was living in my homeland of Dagda, up until the Imperial Army destroyed it 10 years ago. But being a mercenary, I have no real allegiance. That's why I'm working here now. Don't worry, though. I don't plan to turn on you.
That's good. I sure as crap have no money to pay you. Everyone's busy. Everyone's non-chat because everybody's busy. I sound like a spoiler brat, I understand that, but still. Yeah. Hi, Dorothy. Let's talk.
This may seem a bit sudden, but I want to thank you, Professor. That is, for letting me live my life the way I want. I've noticed you've been giving me fewer of those soul-revealing gazes lately. I appreciate you making an effort to not trouble yourself.
We've been back for like a week. Sure.
I was an orphan, living in the back alleys of Enbar, until one day I was overheard singing. That was when my new life began. I was suddenly a songstress in the Mittelfranc Opera Company. Performers, nobility. I met so many people. But none of them ever really knew me. I was just some young, pretty girl who could sing. A spectacle to be admired.
Yep.
Even though everyone praised my looks, my voice, showered me with gifts. I knew one day I'd be old. My looks would fade. My voice would change. I wouldn't sound the same. And I started to wonder, when I did get old, what would I have left? I'd be old. Alone. And back on the streets of the capital, right where I'd started.
Nah. You can come with us. You can stay in the monastery. We'll offer you a teaching position. You know what? That'd be kind of cool, because she could teach drama and, like, acting and singing. She couldn't do it herself, but she could still teach it, so technically, no, you would have a teaching position if everything went according to plan, which I hope it does. You won't be alone.
That's sweet of you. Even if you are just I never had much to begin with in life, and I worry that one day I'll be that way again. That's why I keep searching for someone who will love me. Someone unaware of the songstress. Who can love a girl that used to be scared.
Well, yes, in truth, that would work ideally, but you also, what I have noticed, you kind of just throw yourself at people in that regards. In the regards of, yes, finding a stable life and whatnot, that's understandable. But in return, you are kind of like, here, take my cockiness and shove it down your throat. Not wrong, ideally not wrong, but not right also at the same time. Not exactly a gray area.
Up at this hour.
I gotta ask you the same question, buddy.
My brain's just busy. Thoughts keep going around and around in there. Meanwhile, my eyes are wide open. At times like this, I like to gaze up at the stars to clear my head. I've been that way since I was a kid. Looking up at the big starry sky makes my dreams feel small, which makes it feel like I can actually make them come true. I didn't believe in gods when I was a kid. Maybe that's because the night sky took their place for me. Hey, Teach, will you talk with me a while?
Sure.
I bet you figured this out, but I wasn't born in Fodor.
Yeah.
Where I come from, the people of Fodor are looked down on as cowards. Technically, that cowardice runs in my veins. On my mother's side, anyway. That's why the people who were around me when I was growing up thought of me as an outsider. But I don't believe the people of Fodor are cowards. That kind of perspective is just based on ignorance. The person from Fodor who I know best is my mother. She fell in love with a man from the wrong side of the border and had the guts to leave home to pursue that love. I always threw that in the faces of anyone who tried to make a fool of me. My mother is proof the people of Fodor aren't all cowards. Just saying that doesn't achieve anything, though. I need to destroy the prejudices that have taken root in my homeland. That's why I came here to see
you know Myron
own eyes.
Or Amara, because you're Myron.
I'd be able to find a new perspective that could help me change things. And what did I find? That the people here view anyone who's an outsider as a beast of sorts. I was shocked. Even though our cultures and beliefs are completely different, our two lands have that much in common. That's when I realized the only way to change things is to bring the whole world together and start anew. That's the dream I've been working toward since I first entered the Officers Academy 5 years ago. To unify the Alliance, and then all of Fodor, and to bring a new set of values to this new land of mine. After that, I'd expand that vision to the rest of the world, break down the walls, and let a new perspective come rushing in, start all over. Do you think that's just a crazy pipe dream, or a brilliant ambition?
I have evidence for both. I have evidence for both, and it hurts me. Okay, chat time. So, a pipe dream. Yes, because someone's going to feel obligated to kill him. And, you know, they're going to feel threatened, like small animals generally do. You know, I compare people with animals a lot. And there's going to be people that are going to put up resistance and then just never give up their ideals. And, like, how are you going to handle that? You're probably going to have to execute them to set an example. Therefore, starting wars and other conflicts that don't... It's different than what you set out to do to begin with, so it will solve that of a prejudice, but it will give more prejudice towards people in general, where it's like, people can't trust one another. People can't do a lot of other things with that. So, it is a pipe dream. But it is also a noble ambition, because it's just like, if you do it correctly, you could get rid of any kind of, like, issues and, like, single out the people that have issues and then correct it in a, not correct it, but, like, more, find ways to work around it. So, if done correctly, it can be true ambitions and whatnot, but if done in such a haphazardly manner, it's going to be a pipe dream. So I have evidence on both sides, both negative and both positive. Oh my god. And also, the starting the world is a new thing. You're pretty much no better than Edelgard with that kind of ambition. Granted, that's understandable, but still. Ah, man, I'm torn on what I want to say. I'm very torn on what I want to say now. Shoot. Also, you guys can hear me, right? Yeah, my microphone's on. You should be able to hear me. What does chat think? I'm torn. I don't want to think. Also, I need to pee, so I'll be right back. So the entire time I was away, no one bothered answering my question, huh? Well, I mean, I know what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna agree with you on that one.
Not too long ago, I would have said it was too much for me to accomplish on my own. But that's not how I feel anymore. And that's because I have you on my side now. Lately, I've spent a lot of time thinking about how I wouldn't have made it this far without you. You and me, Teach, we can go anywhere, do anything. I hope that you always walk in step with me. At least, until the day comes when we can look out at the peaceful world we've built together.
Right, side quest shenanigans.
Do you have time for a request? You've done me a great service.
Welcome. Please come again.
I got a favor to ask. What? Professor?
Use a hand.
I need a favor.
That's a straight run, so screw a lot of things right now. I'm kind of curious if we should do the last run of this game proper for LP purposes if we should just play on hard mode. I'm kind of... I might regret that decision. I might ask chat to not do that for me and stuff, but... I mean, it'll be up to you guys. And also, if we do it on hard mode, oh god, we are taking a break in this very easily. We'll probably have, like, one night this, one night something else. Because I feel like hard mode will honestly kill me. Okay, 5,500 points of renown, and that should be decent. I think we have enough to at least finish off one of the saints, so we get that done. We just have to worry about the other two, and then when those are done, we can just worry about unlocking all the job classes at that point. And it's like, you know, hey, mission one. Let's start off with like. Of Dark Knight and have all the magical spells just to get out there and murder a ton of people. Don't think I won't. I'm gonna go mess up food.
Need something?
Yes! Yes! Should I hold off, or should I start working on this one, too? Axe skill authority. That's experience. I think I want to experience more than anything. I mean, I guess I'll just be talking to myself, because no one's here. Ash probably has to deal with something personal, so I'm not going to really hold her to her chat obligations, but... yeah. Good to know I'm so boring that no one wants to chat.
Okay.
Well, in that regards.
There's always something. It never ends. Lately, I have been feeling uneasy. Impatient. Edelgard claims victory after victory. She never stops.
You're supposed to get this back when he was a kid.
And swept away the corrupt nobles, my father included. I always thought I would be the one to unseat him. But she did it instead. With all the ease and indifference of someone cracking an egg. She put my father under house arrest. She stripped House Eyre of its power. Rather than accepting a role as her puppet, I left. Now I fight to topple the Empire.
Oh, wait, never mind. You're supposed to have this at this point.
Obvious. She never stops moving forward. Single-minded. Never wavering. But where does that leave me? Here, flailing about, going nowhere, contributing nothing.
That's not true.
But it is. That is the reality. Not once since our days at the Academy have I exceeded Edelgard's abilities. I saw her as a worthy opponent. She did not even see me as a contender. She did not even consider me at all. As the head of the Noble House Eyre, I must be able to achieve results. But all my efforts have come to nothing. Results are everything. I have not shown results. So I will be stagnating here forever. I appreciate that. But it is not enough to persuade me. I know that I have a massive wall to climb, and I must climb it alone. Even so, may I ask a favor?
Sure.
Professor, please keep an eye on my progress. I would appreciate if you were always by my side, bearing witness to my accomplishments.
Okay. Okay. I want to pair up everyone with everyone at least once. Let's pair up Claude with Annette. Claude with Annette. Here we go. Lawrence with Leonie? No, Dorothea. Lawrence. Unless Dorothea hates this, she doesn't hate this.
I did not expect much from the dining hall.
I think I.
Okay, going down the list, Raphael. Raphael and Dorothea. Or Bernadetta, rather. There's Bernadetta.
This is...
Okay, after Raphael, Ignatz. Ignatz with... Let's go with Leonie, I guess.
That.
Lycidia, Lycidia. Yeah, I'll put you with. If I freaking can, holy crap. Right at the cusp. Son of a...
My apologies. You and the professor are both so fascinating, I simply cannot...
Hey, Marian, you can talk. Hilda... And... Oh my god. Hilda and Sedef. Build a set if.
Yummy.
The flavor is nostalgic.
I think we did Leone, right? Yeah, I'm pretty sure we did Leone. Fernand and I don't know who Fernand. Oh. Oh, I can't cook. Well, I mean, in that case, please let there be something I can fish and cook.
Hmm.
Platinum fish, cool. I please make anything? No. Well then,
members, be safe. We have an air cutting.
Professor, I have written to my father to signal my intention to remain here. Not that I require his approval to do so. There is not much for me to gain by returning to Alliance territory now. But by staying, I will be able to influence the course of events directly on the field of battle. Naturally, someone needs to make certain he does not lead the Alliance to ruin.
This experience is critical.
Thank you, Flynn.
Ask of me. I shall see it through. You saved my life, and I am in your debt.
Thank you, Flynn. Train me in crafting magic. I will probably proceed to never use. Manually, of course. War cancel! Yay! War! Kill team! You know what? I don't honestly give a crap what you learned at this point.
Let's do this again sometime.
Challenge for me. It was a... I've come to understand it quickly. I must...
Oh, yeah, recovering. Good for you.
That was adequate.
Good for damn you. As for you, as I said, don't give crap.
Looks like I got it right.
You really think I'm that great?
Good boy. You learn stuff. Ignatz. I don't really know what you're going to learn. Learn more magic. I want you to spit fire and crap lightning and other crap. Crap out a blizzard for all I care.
Gotta keep working hard. It was quite a challenge.
Okay, Marianne, you had to learn reason.
I managed to get it. Oh, I'll get the next one too.
Hilda, I think you're fine, actually. Leonie is, like, the one I'm not really... Yeah, let's give Leonie more stuff to learn. There. And now for group assignments. Claude, and who needs to be paired up right now? Anyone still need to be paired up with Claude, Annette, Ingrid, Flane, you're fine, Shamir. Annette, take to the skies! When you're done, Claude's out of there.
Professor. I've something I'd like to ask you.
Okay, Professor. When I do enough of fighting, my spirits falter and my loss. The will to keep things tidy, and that's when my realize falls into disorder and disarray. My spirits flow more. There's no way to break the cycle. I'm sure you could just ask someone to help clean your room. You should take a break. Or take a short break and do something to raise your spirits. What if you let it get messy? Take a break.
What a superior answer.
Leonie, sure. I have not used your bow for shab. I want to use my bow more! You're not using your damn bow.
Professor, you're always watching over me, aren't you? I've spent my entire life avoiding people. Speaking to others was so difficult for me. So I made a point to always be alone. Animals and the goddess were the only ones I could really open up to. Do you remember the time you asked what it was I prayed for?
Whoops, that's not good. That's how you spell that, me.
To accept me for who I am now, in spite
Good.
Of my crest. And I have you watching over me. I finally learned to accept.